The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, let us take a moment to acknowledge our sins, so that we may prepare ourselves to celebrate these sacred mysteries. Lord Jesus, your mighty God and Prince of Peace, Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you are the Son of God and the Son of Mary, Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you are Word made flesh and the splendor of the Father, Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy upon us, forgive us of our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. God, Almighty Giver of every good gift, put into our hearts the love of your name, so that by deepening our sense of reverence, you may nurture in us what is good, and by your watchful care keep safe what you have nurtured. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen. Reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, I could not talk to you as spiritual people, but as fleshly people, as infants in Christ. I fed you milk, not solid food, because you were unable to take it. Indeed, you are still not able, even now, for you are still of the flesh. While there is jealousy and rivalry among you, are you not of the flesh and walking according to the manner of a man? Whenever someone says, I belong to Paul, and another, I belong to Apollos, are you not merely men? What is Apollos, after all? And what is Paul? Ministers through whom you became believers, just as the Lord assigned each one. I planted, Apollos watered, but God has caused the growth. Therefore, neither the one who plants nor the one who waters is anything, but only God who causes the growth. He who plants waters are one, and each will receive wages in proportion to his labor. For we are God's co-workers. You are God's field, God's building. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Our song response is, My Soul is Thirsty.
My soul is thirsty for you, O Lord, thirsty for you, my God. My soul
After Jesus left the synagogue, he entered the house of Simon. Simon's mother-in-law was afflicted with a severe fever, and they interceded with him about her. He stood over her, rebuked the fever, and then left her. She stood up immediately and waited on them. At sunset, all who had people sick with various diseases brought them to him. He laid his hands on each of them, curing them. And demons also came out from many, shouting, "You are the Son of God." Then he rebuked them and did not allow them to speak, because they knew he was the Christ. At daybreak, Jesus left and went to a deserted place. The crowds looked over him, and when they came to him, they tried to prevent him from leaving them. But he said to them, To the other towns, I also must proclaim the good news of the kingdom of God, because for this purpose I have been sent." And he was preaching in the synagogues of Judea, the gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Please be seated. In our day-to-day lives, we are to proclaim the good news, and that's by the way in which we live our lives. If we are truly sons and daughters of our Lord and brothers and sisters in Christ, we love thy neighbor as thyself, meaning we treat each other with the utmost respect, and we treat everyone that we meet or come in contact with the utmost respect. And by doing that, we show them that we love Christ and we love them also. As we go out each and every single day, let us treat everyone, our mom, our dad, our aunt, uncle, our grandpa, grandma, and our brothers and sisters, and our classmates and teachers with the utmost respect. With one heart, let us offer our prayers to the Lord. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we receive the bread we offer you. For the earth and work of human hands will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you. Through the divine work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands, for the praise and the glory of his name, for our good and all of his holy church.
May this sacred offering, O Lord, confer on us always the blessing of salvation, that when it celebrates the mystery it may accomplish in power through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty, and Father God, for although you have no need of our praise, you have our thanksgiving as a self to your giving. Since our praise has done nothing to your greatness but profit for our salvation, through Christ our Lord. And so, in company with the choirs and angels, we praise you, and with joy we proclaim.
Holy, holy.
In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
Save us, Savior of the world, for by
we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope, Charles our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Our Father. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from our evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may always be free from sin and safe from all distress as we await the blessed hope of the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity, in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other a sign of God's peace. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord,
I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Renew by this bread from the heavenly table, we beseech you, Lord, that being the food of charity, may confirm our hearts and us to serve you and our neighbor through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Mass is ended. Let us go in peace.